Last year, my family took a vacation to Florida. One of our stops was to a beach on the Gulf of Mexico. While there, I did whatever I could to escape my sisters and brother. I mean, have you ever seen my sisters in a bikini? Have you ever seen my brother in a bikini? Back to my point. So, I took a walk on the beach, anywhere but where they were. I saw trash everywhere on the beach. It was terrible. And then I saw a turtle lying there, suffering. But he had the coolest necklace on. And he had a nose ring too. I'll get that out for you, buddy. There we go. Then I saw the coolest thing. I saw that oil-covered duck from the soap bottle. You know, those Dawn commercials that make you feel all warm and cuddly inside? All right, now I think you guys know which duck I'm talking about. Anyways, back to my point. People are always saying that littering is a problem, but maybe, just maybe, it's actually a good thing. See, I believe trash should go to the ocean because it takes up 71% of the earth, is undrinkable, and is the perfect receptacle for trash. And why waste all that precious land on Earth when we can turn the ocean into even more precious land for us to use? That's what I always say. Littering doesn't clutter our lives, it cleanses it. So let's put on our gloves as we dive deeper in the dumpster while we crumple up the definition of littering, pick our spot for the benefits, finally toss out what you can do to litter more for everyone to see. First, we will crumple up the definition of littering. The Merriam-Webster Dictionary says that littering is, a covered and curtained couch for carrying. No, that's not right. There we go. Material used is bedding. No. The offspring of one at birth. Trash or waste paper scattered about. Now that's more like it. Whereas my definition is a bit different than Merriam-Webster's. I think that it is fulfilling my calling to make our lives more livable. That doesn't tell you how to litter though. So first, let me explain. You go to your favorite fast food restaurant. I picked McDonald's. Then you grab the trash from it and crumple it up with all of your energy to find the worst possible place you could put it and deposit it there. Now let's review. Is it littering or is it not? Throwing your trash in the streets, that's littering. No, I don't have my magnets. What am I gonna do? Oh wait, gum. Then, with that clearly being littering, let's pick a harder one. Throwing a baby's diaper on the beach. Not littering. No, it's really not. Throwing your baby on the beach. That's littering. Because that trash never stops crying. Planting a tree. That's littering. Did you know that plant has microplastics? Throwing a lit cigarette out. No, it's not littering. It could be burning down all those trees, littering the environment. Now that we have crumpled up the definition of littering, let's pick our spot as we explore the benefits of littering. The first and most scummy way that littering benefits us is it kills all the life in the oceans between turtles, sharks, and the Loch Ness Monster. Do you like scary sea creatures? Hence the point, kill them all. Ocean plants are only responsible for 70% of life on Earth. We could survive for at least a week before it became a problem. We could get all the big oil companies to dump their waste in the oceans, then we could experience the benefit of undrinkable water. Then, with all the ocean being terrible, we could get all those stupid coastal cities to be completely relocated. If we're lucky, we'll stay in Florida. In an article by The Onion, did you know that littering can reduce your stress by nearly 100%? It also found that people who refuse to litter are guaranteed to disagree with you politically. So, with all that trash all over, everywhere, there would be so much in the ocean that we could build houses on it and send our prisoners there. Dethrone Australia as the worst place to live. Then, with all the trash there, we could use more land if we repurpose the landfills and turn them into new housing districts. We could build houses and schools and playgrounds on the dump. Kids would have so much fun playing in the dumps, just like we did when we were younger. Did you never have fun playing in the dump as a kid? Such a sad childhood. Now that we have picked our spot for the benefits, finally we will toss out what you can do to litter more for everyone to see. One time, I was visiting a friend of mine's. When I saw his house and the condition it was in, I was scared. But once inside, it seemed so calming. Hoarders can find anything, I mean anything, in their own home, even if they didn't put it there, which was cool and all, but what really sold it to me was how bad for the environment it was. There was trash everywhere, in their yard, in their street, absolutely everywhere. And they barely had any room for trash in their house. So, I mean, as a hoarder, I do whatever I can to clean out my house regularly so there's more room for more trash in my house and more trash outside. Yes, I live in a trash can. Don't ask about it. So, I do whatever I can to get my trash cans in a terrible spot. Like, I mean, I always kick them down whenever I see them, because it's just free trash for everywhere. And I mean, as Oscar the Grouch once said, the rent was cheap and I love trash, so I lived in a trash can myself. What's wrong with that? So we don't have to worry about where our trash goes or who lives in it. I love you, Oscar, but... So, whenever I see trash, I always try to put it all in the ocean because it really belongs there. Personally, though, my favorite trash is styrofoam. I can throw it around and treat it terribly and it'll stick around for like 500 years, just like your mother did. And you can make plastic explosives, that too. So today, we crumpled up the definition of littering, picked our spot for the benefits, and finally tossed up what you can do to litter more for everyone to see. So when you leave from here, don't put your trash in the trash can. Instead, find somewhere better, your own backyard. Or even better, you could put it in the Gulf of Mexico or the Platte River, and it would eventually lead to the Gulf of Mexico, and it could hopefully make its way to a turtle.